Hey guys, I just started this draft champions. I'm gonna sleep today, so.
A new era begins today. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions. The Steelers interplay this afternoon, ready to see what they've got and how or if these pieces are gonna fit together. They'll square off here against the team that'll be the Pittsburgh Steelers.
This game has officially begun. Ross has got it. And the tackle is made right around the 25-yard line. Davis is alone in the backfield. He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Down the field, makes the catch. Deep down the middle of the field. Still the prettiest play.
That's why we ain't at it tomorrow. Then. Yes. On what game? Rod 35-81. Yeah, that's Kevin Durant and Metatron. Yeah. Okay. I'm on air right now. Look at this. I'm on air. Look. Yeah. I got my. Say what's up to my YouTube dad. Yeah. I'm on YouTube. Yeah. I sound like a combo.
1 week in and feeling good. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden Draft Champions. The Steelers were able to get that all-important first win in the opener and take that first step towards becoming a title contender. They'll score out here against the team that'll be up for them, the Pittsburgh Steelers.
I'm feeling this time.
This game is underway. Martin's got it on the return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
How's that? Answer.
The Steelers come out in a two tight end set. The Steelers will take the snap from the 25. Here Here's a look at the offense, and watch out today for Demaryius Thomas, who is tremendous after the catch.
Yes!
That we say and we mean it, adore.
Yes. I'm back, guys. Huh? I'm about to go and see now. Is it data takeover? Day takeover? Day takeover. D-A. Yeah, that's what I said.
It's on the field here. Did not beat the play clock. And now, after the penalty, it's second down and 15. One player looking to be in the quarterback space today is Elvis Dumervil.
Elvis Dumervil, they told him he was too short in high school. He was too short at the University of Louisville. And all he has done is just sack quarterbacks since he's been in the NFL.
Ball's incomplete. Fourth down coming up. Looks like they'll go three and out on this series. The Steelers will risk it here, going for it on fourth here in the first quarter. The Steelers need to get to the 35 to pick up a first. Launches it down the field. Thomas is going to pull in the bullet pass. The Steelers know that a fourth down conversion like that could be a momentum changer.
Oh, sure it can. It gives everybody confidence. You get to call at least three more plays, you hope. And anytime you stay on the field longer in the NFL, the odds go up tremendously that you're going to get a score. Nice risk-reward play that time on the offensive side.
After the two-yard carry, it sets up second down and eight. Tough start for the quarterback. An early interception.
Oh, the worst thing you can do as a quarterback, but I'm giving the defense here a lot of credit. They diagnosed the play. They took advantage of the quarterback, and they got the interception.
They'll go ground. They tack on for a loss.
Steelers defense is so fast and so powerful. That time on the run play, they just overpower the offensive line. They tackle the runner for a loss.
Second and 11. Out again. And Woodley in on the tackle. A reception on second down, but not enough for the first. Third down. They'll run it here. The tackle is made, and the first down is picked up. First and 10. They'll stay on the ground on first down. For about four. And it'll be second down and six after the running play on first down. He'll take the snap from the gun. Hasselbacks running away from the pressure. The defense has the football.
That is not a turnover. That is truly a takeaway by the defense. Their hustle to the football, the hard hitting, that's what got them to take away. the Steelers offense can reignite things now after last time moving the football only to throw a drive-ending interception.
And this is what this defense lives on. They thrive on it. They let you move the football a little bit, but they wait for that mistake. Is that mistake going to be an offensive penalty, a drop pass? That time it was an interception, so that's what this defense does, and they do it well.
Intercepted.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Steelers have now for this next drive. And, of course, we met with the coaching staff this week, and the one thing they emphasized, we cannot fumble the football. But that's just what they did the last time they were out here.
Well, don't we see that when we go to their practices?
Hey.
We see all the drills, the receivers, the runners, the quarterbacks moving through things. People trying to take the football away because you've got to be ready for the
targets.
And know the defenders are always reaching to take the football away from them.
How many drills did we watch this week when we attended practice where it was all about ball security?
Huh?
We saw a lot. I guarantee there will be more of them this week.
Third and 13. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. The Steelers will go for it here on fourth down and a short yardage situation. Draw play here. The Steelers turn the ball over on downs.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short game.
The Steelers will try to put a little drive together and not give the football away, Phil, as each team seems to like one on treat it like it's a hot potato.
Well, sometimes it is a hot potato.
Taking it all the way home for the touchdown. Phil, that's a terrific touchdown here late in the first, and they've now taken the lead.
Shoot, touchdowns are terrific no matter what time you get them, though, Jim. But, hey, late in the first, what a way to answer for that offense. That was a really, really sharp drive.
He's got a chance to return this one.
Ooh.
And he's going to be brought down right around the 33-yard line. The Steelers take it from the 33. They've got him behind the line of scrimmage.
The Steelers running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards and take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
He's trying to throw the tag in.
Now, looking at third down. Hasselback's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap. Hasselback standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Johnson's got the catch and the first. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field. Welcome back to the action on a day where defenses have ruled. The line of scrimmage is at the 40. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Into the open.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
The Steelers snap it at the 31. They hand it off to him again.
You're running back in this league, and you pick up first downs, and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more care.
First down at the 25. Run it right.
What? Yeah.
He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day. They come to the line at the 24. Second and 10. Toss play to Bernard. Pure determination. What a run. Touchdown. Phil, we're early second quarter, and things suddenly are all back to square one. All tied up after that touchdown.
This game is shaping up to be something special. Really, I like the feel of it. It's exciting. Can't wait to see what happens here the rest of this quarter.
So they give up the touchdown, but they do not allow the two-point play.
Yeah, good job that time by the defense. So quick and so ready for that play. They reacted very fast. That's why they stopped it.
able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Steelers offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
Getting away from the pressure. Pick gives them a chance to perhaps take the lead here early in the second if they can put together a drive.
Jim, I'm really anxious to see what the offensive coordinator calls here in this situation. He's got to be smart and show this defense something they haven't seen already.
The defense, a little jumpy right there. Coming up to the line of scrimmage at the 11. Here's the handoff.
First down by the offense inside the red zone. Can the defense show them something different here and keep them from scoring a touchdown?
The Steelers will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down. Stepping up to the line at the 5. First and goal from the 5. Trying to power his way right up the middle. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody
over the line. Touchdown. Midway through the second quarter, they put themselves in front with that touchdown, Phil.
Hey, that touchdown could be a difference maker in this game. You never know, so really well called by the offensive coordinator and executed perfectly by the offensive players. Hey, I like the play. Really creative thought process there, and the offense caught the defense by surprise.
The Steelers set to return the kick. It's Keyshawn Martin on the return.
When you get a kick return for a touchdown, a lot has to happen. One, it takes talent by the kick returner, but look at all the good blocks we saw down the field and the speed of the kick returner. Touchdown.
Takes off from the 5. And they stop him from running it out to the 20.
Hey.
Mark him down at the 19. The Steelers will look to get set. Been a close game so far. The scores 14-14. Trying to hook up with Jennings that time, but this pass goes incomplete. Second down and 10. Another takeaway. And in for the touchdown.
Well, when you study the offense and you know what they're going to do, you're able to make plays like that. You time the interception perfectly, you make the catch, and you take it all the way back for the score.
I let him in.
The Steelers setting up here for the kickoff. And he'll start his return. More kick coverage on the return, and now the offense comes onto the field, having to feel like it's just been given a big boost of confidence. The Steelers snap it at the 41. An open lane. Picks up 8 here. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
If you think you can get a playoff quickly and not use a timeout, you go with the hurry-up offense. That time, a good job by the coach and the quarterback.
He's now over 60 yards rushing on the ground.
Well, we got a close game here right before half. Good job by the offense deciding to go into hurry-up offense. What you need here, as many plays as you can get and use up as little time as possible.
Hurry up. Two-minute offense. And the pass goes incomplete. Flowers in on the coverage.
Well, I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third long situation for the offense to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker. Well, in a situation like this in the first half, fourth down and near midfield, if it was really short, you think about maybe going for it, but fourth and long, no decision. You got to punt the football away and rely on your defense.
The Steelers don't want any part of punting the football. They're going to go for it on fourth down. The Steelers lined up in the nickel. The Steelers get set at the line, needing to get to the 30 for a first. The Steelers snap it at the 41. Hasselbeck's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under. The Steelers turn the ball over on downs. The Steelers have to call one right here, and they do, and they are out of timeouts. Takes it from the gun.
Wants to go deep.
He reaches up and grabs it. Incredible catch there by the receiver as he goes vertical and comes down with the football and the catch.
We see these incredible catches every single week. Right now, the most talented guys in the NFL might be the wide receivers. They can just do everything. Run, jump, run routes, and make these incredible catches.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. He'll pick up seven this time.
The offense is so close right here. They just need to show a little power and punch this in the end zone and get that touchdown.
We've reached halftime, and we'll be sending it back to our studio and Larry Ridley as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports. With this kick, the second half is underway. He'll take it from the 10. And he's going to be brought down right around the 33-yard line. The Steelers talk things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Catch the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
And he makes the catch. No, the defense. The ball comes out. The ball is knocked out of his hands.
Defense, baby. Don't worry about it.
Matt Hasselbeck will take it right from the center. It's wide open. And pick up about four. He's now over 60 yards rushing on the ground. And now they're in the hurry up. The Steelers from the 37. Outside now on the toss. The Steelers elect to go for it and bypass the punt on fourth down. With drop back. Hasselbeck's on the move. Hauled in by Alex Smith.
I think we heard this all week long, didn't we, Jim? They wanted to be aggressive in this football game, and they're calling the plays and managing of the game, but you're losing. It's close. You go for it on fourth down. That's a lot to try to overcome.
The Steelers step up to the line, employing now their jumbo package. Here we have second down. Sanchez is going to take it from the gun. Demaryius Thomas with the grab. The line of scrimmage, the 36. From the gun, Mark Sanchez ready for the snap.
Third and four.
Looking to go down the field here.
And that incompletion is going to bring us to a very quick fourth down.
Yeah, I'm coming.
The offense back on the field here for this fourth and four. Play clock's running down. Unable to beat the down clock, and that'll cost him 5 yards, a delay of game. The play clock's running down. Offense a little too slow getting set at the line on that one. The Steelers not punting. Going to go for it on fourth down. The Steelers come to the line. First down marker is at the 32. Going for the deep ball. It's intercepted.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
The Steelers retaking the field with their offense in a game that hasn't been very pretty here of late. Turnovers by both teams on the last two possessions.
Well, define the word pretty. I think if you ask the defensive teams, hey, they love this game. It's beautiful. So far, the takeaways by the defense, that's the story.
Yes!
Time for the hurry-up offense.
Okay, I'm coming.
Second and 10. Gets the handle here. Picked up a couple that time.
Oh, why is not letting me pull?
To the 17-yard line for a first down. Hasselbacks got it in the gun. Going for the home run. Great grab there. Snags it with one hand.
The Steelers did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and you know you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Hasselbeck's completion percentage, 40% on the day. That's his first reception today.
Coming to the line at the 24.
First down following the long play. Handoff. Bernard out to the right. Landry's in on the tackle. They're in the hurry-up mode. The Steelers from the 22. Hasselbeck's gonna scramble. And the pass is thrown away.
Well, I'll give the quarterback a lot of credit here as he dropped back, nobody open. Instead of just freezing there, he jumps out of the pocket, looks down the field, nobody open, and a good job. Just throw the football away.
The Steelers get set at the line, needing to get to the 14 for a first. Brandon Flowers picks off that pass. No one's going to get him now. The 30, the 20, the 10. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
You got to love that from your defense. They take a chance. They get the interception. Not only do they do that, they return it a long way for the touchdown.
The Steelers getting set now for the point after. The point after is good. The Steelers set to return the kick. He'll have a chance to take off. Taken down at about the 33, maybe the...
Line. The Steelers' offense back on the field as this game has turned into just a big mess, Phil, as no one seems to be able to hold on to the football.
Nobody can hold on to the football. The play is sloppy. The calling of the plays has also been, I think, a little sloppy. Give these guys a better chance to make some positive plays.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt.
The Steelers lined up, bunch formation to the ground. That gains a few.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game.
The Steelers from the 37. Airing it out. Clutch catch.
Well,
don't look at the scoreboards, which tells you you're down by a couple scores. Just concentrate on every single play and try to get another first down.
The Steelers offense tries to continue some momentum, still possessing the football as the final quarter gets underway. Quarter begins with this snap. He's now over 80 yards rushing on the day.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back. When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
Good for only a yard. No huddle time. Second and goal from the 8. Hasselbeck's taking off. Runs it in for the touchdown. That's an important touchdown for this resilient bunch that just never quits, never believes it's out of a game, Phil.
That's what it takes, Jim. In situations like this, you just have to be tougher than your opponent, and that's what they showed there. Getting that touchdown, now we are going to have a contest down here in the fourth quarter.
Martin's going to test the coverage here. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Steelers are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You got to go out there and be much better.
The Steelers defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Second down and 10. Catch made by Demaryius Thomas.
The Steelers offense has been tough today. They are fighting out there on the field. That's a nice job picking up that first down. It's been fun to watch. They got a small lead here in the second half. We'll see if that first down can lead them to a score.
You knew this was going to happen, and the coach disagrees with the call on the field. So he challenged the play, and the coach's challenge does not pay off.
Well, I agree with the head coach still. I would have made this challenge because it was so important to the outcome of the game, and it was a little bit of a gamble, but it was worth it.
Leading and with possession of the football, a good place to be at this point in the game. The defense gets a sack.
Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad. After getting sacked like that by the defensive end, your offensive tackle's just got to do a better job.
If they're going to have any chance at all here late in the fourth, the defense must make a big stop and give the ball back to the offense.
And it falls incomplete.
Well, the most common thing that most offensive coordinators do in the NFL on third long situations, they're going to call a play where they probably don't think they're going to pick up the first down, but they're looking for field position.
That last pass incomplete, and it brings up third down. From the gun, Mark Sanchez ready for the snap. They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. Sanchez with the deep throw. Pass is intercepted.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Steelers take the field again on offense. They'll be looking for a repeat of their last drive. They came away with a touchdown and really had the defense on its heels.
Well, it's going to be hard to repeat what they just did because it looked so easy, and it was well done by their offense. And I think when you talk about situations like this, it really comes down to one thing. Can the offensive line continue to dominate?
Time is running out. The defense knows it's playing with the lead, but doing whatever it can to just try to run out the clock.
Toss play. Gaines, 17.
The Steelers look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Flip to the outside.
And they tackle him down at the 37-yard line. And now we reach the two-minute warning. Every play is huge now. Second down on the way. We're drawing near a close, and the defense is trying to preserve a victory.
Denard's there to make the tackle. Coming up, third down, a huge moment.
You know, you go to the hurry-up offense so you can get a high number of plays in, but also you don't want to use the timeout.
Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way.
The defense here must not panic. They know that they're going to be facing this hurry-up offense, a team that's desperate.
Yeah, that's right. They know the situation. Don't give up the big play. And if you can tackle somebody in bounds, make sure you get it done.
Second and 10.
Strong eye, handoff here. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play. Third down coming up, needing a first at this point. Takes another handoff. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down. The Steelers coming to the lines. They'll have all three of their timeouts here in the fourth quarter.
This is a pretty easy decision for the coach here. You're down. It's late in the game. Get in that hurry-up offense. Preserve time and get as many plays off as you possibly can. Good job by the offense going the hurry-up offense. You do this to get the plays in, but also you want to conserve the timeouts.
Touchdown, Pittsburgh Steelers. And a second touchdown on the game.
Anytime you see a long run for a touchdown, what you got to look for is blocking downfield. Nice job by the wide receivers and everybody hustling, making a block and a long touchdown run.
Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. They will not find a way into the end zone, so they'll only get 6 points out of the trip. The Steelers set to return the kick. To get out to the 20, and he is smacked down at the 15-yard line. The Steelers offense getting ready to start this drive, and things are looking good for them at this stage of the game, partner.
Yeah, this is where it gets tough, though, Jim. They got to find a way, make the right play call to get one first down. If you do that, that puts the other team in a very tough situation. Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
The Steelers set at the line. Dime package. Second down and 10. And incomplete as Thomas can't hold on.
Interesting situation here for the offense. They got a lead here in the second half, but it's third and long. And you always like to say, the football is in the hands of the quarterback, so he has to be smart. If he tries to force it down the field, I do not like his chances. They know if they give up a first down, the game is probably over. They get fooled and they give it up. Probably why they're going to lose.
The Steelers lined up. Everybody split out wide. Looking long. Wow, what a catch. That's his first reception today. The Steelers will call for the timeout. They need every second to be preserved at this point.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
And it's good. In the waning moments, this should all but give them the win.
Nowadays, so many kids, they grow up, they want to be wide receivers. I don't blame them. They're out there, they get to catch the football, they get to score touchdowns, they get to do dances, and you're not really allowed to hit them either. What a job.
They're setting up the return. The Steelers' offense takes the field, and they are absolutely in desperate need of a big-time drive here to put points on the board.
The one thing we do know, since you are behind, the defense most likely is going to be very conservative the first couple calls. So make sure you have play calls to take advantage of the fact that they're going to be very conservative on the defensive side.
The Steelers will take the snap from the 40. Going deep. What a catch. One-handed. The Steelers call for a timeout. They want to talk it over on what should be coming up, the final play of the game. The Steelers' last snap. Let's see what they can do here. Quarters formation here for the defense. First down at the 22. Hasselbacks on the move. Hale almost gets the pick. For Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.